Hi everyone, welcome to Heather's Art Adventures. I hope you're ready to have some fun.
Well, I know I'm ready to have some fun, so welcome to Heather's Art Adventures. This is going to be a grand one. So a big huge thank you goes out to Kelz Kidz for these awesome tote bags. There are more videos that are coming as to what we're going to do with these. I think this particular tote bag is perfect to use as a reusable shopping bag, which was my idea when I got these. And I'm going to be doing lots more videos. I've got some painting thoughts and all kinds of ideas. But anyway, that's for another video. So thanks so much for joining me to watch this. This actually is taken from a live stream that we did on Twitch, and I've cut it down, sped it up a little bit, and I'm going to be doing this, giving you some tips and stuff. The first tip is iron your bag before you paint. Some things I learn afterwards. All right, so we're going to be working with the Gelli Arts Mini Hexagon, and this is a part of a three-piece set, so you can get more than one shape in that set. And then I just used the hexagon, put it onto a stamp block, and then we're going to use this fabric painting medium by Deco Art, and this stuff is awesome. I'm using regular Deco Art paints, just Americana paints, craft paints. Any kind of craft paint would work for this. And then I've also got a couple of golden high flow acrylic paints that I'll use too, just because they happen to be on my desk. So I'm using a larger square, the 5x5 student kit Gelli plate, and this is in real time speed right here, and I'm mixing up the color along with that fabric painting medium, and I'm using that sort of like a palette. Okay, so I'm mixing up my ink on, or my paint, sorry, on the palette, and then the idea was to then brayer off or smoosh or whatever I'm going to do with the hexagon. And I apologize because to start off right off the bat, I'm going to go straight down to the bottom where you can barely see, but trust me, eventually you'll see this stuff. I do fix it later on, so stick with me. I'm just doing the bottom here. I'll move it up a little bit so you can see, but this is all in real-time speed. Now, I've got another pro tip for you if you decide to do something like this. Cut a piece or several pieces of paper the size of your mini plate, because right here you can see me doing like an eyeball spacing so that I've got it like don't stamp here, leave a blank so I can put a different color there, and then I move over. It would have been so much easier if I had like a couple templates of, you know, the hexagon that I could put on and keep my spacing better. But I think we did pretty good without it, but it's just a tip in case you decide you want to do this. Now you will see on occasion a couple of comments pop up like it just did. That's just proof that we do have a live studio audience. Well, they're in studio in my mind anyway, watching us live when we are live every weekday on Twitch at 10 a.m. Eastern if you're interested in watching that. I've decided to move my live streams over to Twitch just because it is more functional for Twitch than it is for YouTube. So while I am going to go ahead and speed this up, I've cut out the process of cleaning my plate and any chit chatter that was going on. It's just all about Gelli plating in this video because I wanted you to get the idea of how you can take a tote bag, one of these awesome tote bags, very well made, and it's got a great gusset so you can use it for your shopping. It's awesome. I'm really liking it, and I've got a couple of sizes. So this one is the large canvas tote, and there is a link down in the description for how you can get yours. There's also the website to kelzkidz.com, so you can go check out what else they have, because they've got a lot of fun things that have nothing to do with tote bags. It's actually kind of a cool website. Anyway, so trying to figure out placement of all these, which was, like I said, a little bit difficult without some sort of placeholder, but it took me an entire video to figure that out, that was a really good idea. So now you see me holding it there for quite a long time, and I have, by the way, sped this video up to third, like three times fast. So it's not double speed, it's triple speed. Anyway, I figured that was fast enough to get us through it, but slow enough that it doesn't look like I'm gone crazy. But anyway, the key when you are working on a non-gessoed canvas, which if you think of this canvas bag, it's the exact same kind of canvas that you would have on a stretched canvas that you would paint on. So if you had put gesso on it, then it would be just like your canvas is, just not stretched, right? Because if it was stretched, it wouldn't have all those wrinkles, or if I ironed it. But anyway, that's another story. So if you took gesso and put that down first, then you'd have this surface that the paint would sit on top of. But because we don't have gesso, it's actually going to soak into the fibers of the canvas. And you really want to leave your jelly plate stamped on there a little bit longer so that that way it will in fact soak into the canvas. So you see me pushing it on there, holding it on there, leaving it on there, checking a couple of comments. And like Nikki said, perfection's overrated, so don't get hung up on it. But there you go. And when you're going through a stencil like that, it really helps to give it a little bit more pressure, and you get some pretty good clean pulls out of that. So now we're going on to another color. So this, I tried to keep them kind of fresh, kind of fun colors. I mean, these are, you could do this. I have an idea to do this in like a monochrome, all one color. Don't you think that would be kind of neat? I've got this stencil for a bee, which I thought would be really cool with these hexagons. You do all yellows and then do like a paint a bee. I think that would be fun. Might try that one. Anyway, I did a couple of different stencils. I thought this one would be fun with those circles. I wasn't sure how to do it. Plus, I wanted to sort of expand our horizons of what the patterns that we had on here. The idea was to just get different patterns, different colors, and spread them out. But I really wanted to focus all of my patterning to the bottom right corner of this bag, and I think we did a pretty good job of it. And I saw all this pattern still left on the plate, and I thought, ooh, do we dare try to do a cleanup pull? Let's give it a shot. Let's see how it works. So here's the trick to a cleanup pull. You've got some great patterning on there, but you want to put on a very light layer of an opposing color. So in this case, it's white, just very contrasting to the pink. And then I'm going to let it sit there. I'm going to let it sit there. I'm going to push, push, push. I'm going to let it sit there. Really let it soak in and then slowly peel it off. It worked. You know, you love it when that happens, don't you? If I had trumpets, I would, you know, just because that's cool. So what do you guys think about these premieres on Tuesday? Do you think this is a fun thing to do together? I'm enjoying it. I mean, just ask me. I'm in the comments right now. You can ask me. If you're watching this in replay, you can ask me. I'll come back and talk to you after the replay is over. All right, so I've got some. This is golden high flow acrylic paint that I mixed with that fabric painting medium. It's very liquidy. It's high flow. So you don't really need a lot. But look at that crisp impression of that rose that it put on there. That's so awesome. Now, the secondary print is going to be a little less defined. I'm just going to spoil it for you right now. It's a little less defined than I thought it would be. And that's okay. It's still a pretty color. So load it up and add some more. I'm really excited about this tote bag fun, because what I'm going to be doing is working on a video. Hopefully every week I'm going to have a new tote bag, way to decorate a tote bag video for you guys, and a couple of different tote bags over time. The company Kelz Kidz has already said that they've got some more bags they want to send me, so I'm very excited about that. Looking forward to it. I hope you are too. So I figured there's like a color missing in all of this, and that was yellow. So I'm going to use that golden high flow, and it is transparent. That's what I was showing there on the bottle. It's very translucent. And I think that's what it needed. Look at that pow. And mixing with that magenta really is kind of a cool patterning. I like that. And I know you can't see it. It's down there at the bottom. Lift it up and show you there. Now I'm doing something when I'm working on these edges to make sure that I get as much to the edge. I'll put my fingers underneath and push up onto the plate. Sometimes you got to do that sort of stuff. But I am trying really hard to keep a crisp edge because, and you'll see in the pictures at the very end of this, you'll see that there are defined lines of where the hexagons end and where the side pocket, the side gusset of the bag are. And I did not finish this bag. I just did the front that you see here in this video, but my intentions are to continue to the other side and maybe do the opposite instead of the bottom left, or I'm sorry, it's the bottom right. Maybe I'd do the top left, or maybe not. I don't know. Maybe I'll just do the bottom left and have it sort of like wrap around. I'm not sure. So I wanted to try, this is a die cut, like leftovers from die cutting, and this is very thick cardstock. And so I thought it would be kind of fun to see if I could put that that plate through that cutout, if it would work. I should have put a label across the top there, but that's fine. Be barely noticeable in the end. But I'm just pushing really good because I can see through that plate and I can see that I made contact with the bag. Very, very successful. I'm very happy with this. It actually made me very happy. The whole darn thing did. That one, not so much. It didn't really come out as well, and I'm thinking, do I really want to mess with it? Do I want to get out some pens? No, no, this is a jelly plating challenge, and we're just going to stick with it. And I thought, well, what if I did, like, you know, the cleanup pull that we tried with the circles? And I'll do it with gold. We'll see what that looks like. So add a little bit of that fabric medium to some very, very translucent gold. And then I thought this would be cool. Have like one random out there by itself hexagon. Wouldn't that be pretty? Well, I guess it wouldn't be all that pretty. So that didn't really work out, but it left sort of like this haze, so I'm gonna have to do something with it. But I also know that there is an amazing print left on this plate, so pause for just a moment while we do a cleanup pull onto paper that I know is probably one of the best pulls I've ever made. Absolutely love this right here. So much so that we're just gonna pause it for a second. Let's take a look. That's what that piece looks like in person. Look at the textures from that canvas bag. That's amazing. Yeah, I wish I could cut it out and stick it right there, but I can't. So, plan B. Plan B. And, well, I'm just going to spoil it for you for just a second. I'm going to slow it down. I'm going to bring it out of the fast mode, and I'm going to actually let you listen to the whole thing once we get to this part. I just decided I'm going to paint it in gold. I'm going to give myself a real nice gold base. Just straight on. And I didn't use any fabric medium for this because I was just a little disturbed about that print not working right. But that's okay. I've got a plan. I'm formulating it. I'm working it. And I probably should have heat set that, but I was really in the mode for making this work. So let's listen in to the live feed, well, as live as it can be, as we get started with this. Oh no, first I apologize. First, I'm going to fill in the gaps with that color because I realized that I still have a couple of spots where I needed some more hexagons on the pattern. And if you notice, I did like three of each color or three of each pattern, or, you know, I really did stick to the threes and bounced around all over the place. So I tried really hard to make that work out as best as I could. But Yeah, that looks pretty good. I could probably do one more, but anyway, so I decide I want to go with that bigger butterfly, have the wings stick out over the edges. And I do tape the edges so that way that other extra stuff doesn't get onto our print, because I am going to use the larger gel plate for this. And we'll go ahead and we'll listen in to me and Jules have a conversation while we put this together and what happens next. Okay, so I have this beautiful color and I have this beautiful magenta we're going to add into this because you know I love
Ooh,
magenta and
purple.
teal. And we're just going to give ourselves a little bit of a typical Kraaft Shaak mixture, right?
Yep.
And using this great bigger, much bigger, I should probably heat set this, but I'm just too excited. All right, I got everything covered. Okay, good. Okay, good. Lord have mercy, please. Everybody say a little prayer. I can't see. Okay, there's the line of the butterfly. There's the line of the butterfly. I see your. Oh, okay, we're just gonna sit there. Okay, this is where you go. One Hail Mary. I don't know. I'm not Catholic, so I don't know how that works. Jelly, are there jelly plate gods? Maybe we pray to them. I don't know. Please let it work. CPR, 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 CPR. Okay.
Andrew says learning with Legos, and Jazzy says, "Oh my, that's so funny! Cannot wait to for t until the revealing."
Okay, it's GPR. I just figured it out. Jelly plate resuscitation. Ready? Here it goes. Here it goes. Are you joking? It didn't work at all. How's that even possible? It never touched it.
I'm
How's that even
confused.
possible? I'm totally confused. What? What? Come on. Okay, pick it up. Push it from underneath. Oh, there. Now I can see that it's actually touching.
Right.
Like, what? Were you guys there? It was like I didn't do a thing. All right, I'm pushing it from underneath, flipping it over. Now we give it GPR. Clear. Okay, here it goes. Oh boy, please let this work for Pete's sake. That was absurd. Okay, here it goes. I have to look. All right, good. Whew.
Wow.
My goodness, I didn't think that was going to work. Well, maybe because it didn't the first time. That could be why I thought that.
Andrew and Lucy are saying that was super funny.
Yeah, for you were sitting on that side of it, you nuts. Okay.
I was like, what's gone
What?
wrong there? There's nothing at all.
You and me both, girl. I was like, I'm confused. I'm very confused. I'm just
Nikki's
gonna.
laughing. She's saying you couldn't have planned that better with all
I wouldn't have wanted to plan that. That was totally not at all on purpose.
the build-up.
Well, if you can't laugh at yourself, who can you laugh at, right? Anyway, it was a good time. We had a great time doing the live stream. And I've had a great time watching this with you all in the audience. I hope you enjoyed these premieres. And you'll stick around to the very end to see all of the pictures, of course, not just this one of that final pull. But there's the bag in its entirety. It's actually a really good sized bag, and it's got a great sized gusset, so it'll hold a lot of groceries. And I can't wait to show you what else I'm going to make with these bags. I hope you've enjoyed this, and you'll give us a thumbs up. Leave
leave some comments if you're watching this in replay. If you've got some ideas for what you'd like to see painted on a bag, let me know. We do